When the Airbus A380 was introduced, many believed that it would mark the end of the original jumbo jet, the Boeing 747. However, the retirement of the A380 program and the phasing out of the 747 tells us that it'll be a rare sight to see both types by the time this decade is over. Nonetheless, at their peak, which aircraft was best, the A380 or the 747? Well, let's compare the two types in today's video. Our comparison today will put the Boeing 747-8 against the most up-to-date version of the Airbus A380-800. We'll pretend that we are an airline that's looking for a large-capacity aircraft for both passengers and cargo. While it goes without saying that a Boeing 747 freight variant would easily beat an A380, as an Airbus cargo variant was never built, we will try to remain fair and imagine that we are primarily a passenger airline first. We'll also be looking for the best flexibility and the most cost-effective operations. Some aircraft might provide a better customer experience when it comes to quieter engines and better cabins. We'll take these into account, but we'll prioritize what looks better on paper. When it comes to passenger capacity, the 747-8i has a maximum capacity or exit limit of 605 passengers. For the A380, that number is 853. Of course, carriers set up their aircraft to how they wish. Lufthansa, the operator that introduced the 747-8 for passenger services, flies the type in four classes. This accommodates 362 passengers throughout its first, business, premium economy, and economy classes. Meanwhile, the largest operator of the A380, Emirates, has three different configurations for the Super Jumbo. A three-class layout for 489 passengers, a slightly denser three-class setup for 517 passengers, and an even more dense two-class configuration for 615 passengers. No matter how airlines configure their cabins, the Airbus A380 pushes the 747 right out of the gate with passenger capacity. In a full economy configuration, the A380 can handle 250 more passengers than the 747. Thus, the winner in terms of capacity is the Airbus A380. Next up is a comparison of aircraft interiors. The two jets were both the epitome of flying with style for their generations. The 747 was indeed a pioneer when it came to spacious cabins while delivering top-quality customer experiences. However, the addition of so much extra cabin space on board an A380 gives it more room for bars, showers, lounges, and full private suites. One thing that the 747 has over the A380 is the creative ways that its early operators marketed the top deck. Delta Airlines' flying penthouse apartments back in the 70s was one example. Regardless, Airbus still wins this round by providing so much space, but still enabling its operators to offer such classy interiors, which include various bar and lounge spaces, multi-room suites, and even showers. Moving on to cargo, freight operations can be a very lucrative source of revenue for carriers. Looking at cargo capacity, the Boeing 747 has more capacity despite having less powerful engines and less thrust. In fact, the 747-8i has cargo volume of 6,225 cubic feet or 176 cubic meters, while the A380 has cargo capacity of 6,190 cubic feet or 175.2 cubic meters. Airbus has leaned hard into serving passengers and let Boeing slip ahead for this category. With society now relying on the delivery of goods more than ever, there could be an extension to the life of the 747, while it's not quite the same with the A380. Our winner for transporting cargo is the Boeing 747. Next is range, a metric where the A380 wins by a little bit. Indeed, the 747-8i has a maximum range of 7,730 nautical miles or 14,315 kilometers, compared to the A380's 8,200 nautical miles or 15,186-kilometre range. Even though the difference is not overwhelming, it is enough to give confidence for ultra-long-haul operators. But just because Airbus's jumbo can hold more fuel doesn't mean that it's any cheaper to run. Boeing claims that the 747-8 is more cost-effective per seat per mile than any other aircraft. It doesn't make much sense to compare the two jets in fuel burn and seat mile cost. The planes are considerably different in size. In this case, the standard metrics to measure efficiency do not come into play. Nonetheless, fuel efficiency is one of the key reasons why operators are choosing to veer away from both types. Next, let's look at how the market has reacted to both of these aircraft and see if a pattern emerges. If we stick to comparing just the 747-8i, then this passenger variant only racked up orders for 48 aircraft. On the other hand, the Airbus A380 had orders for 251 examples. This huge lead was largely made possible through Emirates' decision to invest heavily in the type, but without help from the Dubai-based airline, the gap would be a little smaller. If we look at total Boeing 747 orders across all variants, then 1,573 airframes have been produced. Given the differences in timing, it's hard to proclaim a winner one way or the other, although it's worth noting that the A380 may have had more orders if the jet came out 20 years earlier. Here is the 2020 list price for each aircraft. Airbus A380, $445.6 million. Boeing 747-8, $402.9 million. The Boeing 747 is actually cheaper to buy and less expensive to operate. It might be smaller in terms of passenger capacity, but in a world where airlines want smaller aircraft that are easier to fill, is that $45 million extra really worth it? This amount is almost $300,000 extra per passenger, which will need to be made up over the lifetime of the jet. Granted, if the A380 had been popular enough to reach higher production capacity, the price might have fallen. Ultimately, however, our winner on price would be the Boeing 747. When it comes to aircraft longevity and practicality, we would again have to proclaim the 747 the winner. Ultimately, the A380 was the realization of a dream, a giant floating village that could fly across continents while fitted with showers, lounges, and more. However, the world quickly moved on. Today, airlines are looking for smaller aircraft that can operate between regional airports, and flying islands just don't have much of a place anymore. If an airline can fill up an entire A380, then it can be a huge profit driver. But that is becoming increasingly rare. Capacity is a crucial pull factor for the A380. Therefore, with more flexible options, the plane is becoming increasingly redundant. It's for this reason that the smaller capacity 747 just seems to win this round. Nonetheless, it is a bittersweet victory as the sun is also setting on the icon. Modern aircraft such as the Airbus A350 and the upcoming Boeing 777X almost match capacity, but with massive improvements in design, cost, and fuel efficiency. Over the decades, Boeing 747 variants have found careers in other fields after being retired by passenger airlines. Other than going on to become cargo units, several additions have been put to use creatively in different ways. For instance, NASA took on a former Pan Am and United Boeing 747 and transformed it into the Stratospheric Observatory for Infrared Astronomy, or SOFIA. Virgin Orbit uses an ex-Virgin Atlantic 747-400 to launch satellites into space. Additionally, a few 747s have been converted into flying testbeds to test the performance of new and developing engines. Indeed, a variety of 747s have found themselves being quite useful even after retirement from regular passenger service. Of course, it's early to say whether the A380 will prove to be as useful in its afterlife. The jet is unlikely to work as a converted freighter, but at least one A380 flies as a testbed for Airbus. Indeed, this particular A380 is being used for testing next-generation fuel solutions such as hydrogen. Ultimately, however, the 747 has already proven its versatility in several ways and is thus our winner when it comes to long-term usefulness. Altogether, the legacy of the Boeing 747 speaks for itself. Despite it being half a century old, it has managed to adapt over the years and still find a role within the industry. Meanwhile, for all its grandeur, several Airbus A380s are being permanently grounded before they could reach their 15th birthday. By the time we reach the 2030s, it could be a real treat to see one in the skies. Ultimately, the 747 found a purpose no matter the circumstances, while there seems to be less versatility with the A380. With all of that said, we have to declare that the overall winner in our comparison is the Boeing 747. Nonetheless, there are undoubtedly those that have their favourites when it comes to the two wide bodies. Moreover, which aircraft is better also comes down to practical use for airlines. If a carrier can continue to fill every seat on its A380 aircraft throughout the years, then the Super Jumbo may be the preferred option. However, the 747 has shown its ability to adapt, and even if it goes on to be a rare sight at passenger airport grounds, it will continue to live for many years in other roles. Ultimately, we'll remember both types as aircraft that push the boundaries of aviation in their own ways. So, what are your thoughts about the Boeing 747 and Airbus A380? Out of the two types, which one do you think is better, and why? Let us know what you think by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.